A huge thanks to my Patreon supporters for making this episode possible. Good morning fellow mathematicians, welcome back to another video. So just a short little video in reference to the community post I posted like an hour ago. In my community tab, check it out if you haven't checked it out already. And I just arrived at home and I think I came up with a solution myself. I'm going to try to go through the solution at the end of the video. But at first, here's the problem. So I'm teaching elementary geometry right now in my sixth grade. My boys and girls are writing a test right now in my class and I had a lot of time to think about God and the world and construction of triangles. And you are probably familiar with the four construction theorems to construct yourself triangles uniquely. And one of these is the SSS one, where you have three sides given and a triangle inequality needs to hold, and then you can uniquely construct a triangle like this. So what you do is you take your straight edge in a normal case, you put your first line segment down, for example A, then you're going to use your compass, you're going to use your ruler too, take the radius, okay, as being for example 7 centimeters, you're going to draw the first arc. Next, line segment, okay, it's going to be 9 centimeters, for example, draw your next arc, and then you can connect your vertex, okay, or your vertices with the intersection point up here. And now I was thinking, what happens if you don't use your straight edge? Can you still construct an SSS triangle without a straight edge? And by that I mean not using the center of the circle, okay, where you pinch into the paper, or maybe just using points that you mark down to create yourself this line segment A that we have right here initially. What I mean by this construction is by using only intersections of circles. This is where I want to go at, and I was thinking about it, and I think you can construct it. And if you haven't tried it out for yourself yet, okay, try it out and then keep watching the video for hopefully the solution. But up until then, okay, I'm going to hop over to Fusion 360 now, because that's way more accurate than using my big old Schlüssel band right here, keyband, and my chalk pen. And yeah, I'm going to see you over in Fusion 360 for the hopefully successful construction, and try it out for yourself if you haven't done so already. So we are in Fusion 360 now, and we're going to go through the solution that I came up with while driving in the car, and I hope everything works out. And just as a little side note, we are allowed to measure the radius of the circle on our compass that we are going to use, obviously, otherwise the construction would not be possible, but we are not allowed to place some kind of line segment into here with a length of 7 centimeters, for example. And we are going to go with a triangle which has the side lengths of length units 7 and 8 and 9, and the triangle inequality holds, so all good. What we are going to do at first is we are going to construct ourselves a circle with radius of one line segment. Really doesn't matter, let's go with the 7 centimeters, meaning we are going to need a circle with diameter of 14. And now what we are going to do is, on the outer arc, we are going to pinch our circle in, and our compass, and what we are going to do now is we are going to take the radius as one of the other side lengths. Let's say 16. Is now the diameter, meaning giving us a radius of 8. Now one thing you are going to notice is that we are going to have two intersection points. And now in a normal case, you can probably mathematically verify this. What I had in mind is I'm going to take another circle with radius 7 yet again, just like the first line segment, and it should intersect once again with our circle of radius 8 centimeters. And this point that is going to be the intersection point should be 7 apart, so 7 length units. So if we were to place a line segment in here, 7 length units, it worked out. Meaning, if we were to connect those two points right here, we are going to get exactly our first line segment. And now the construction is just a regular one that we are used to, pinching our compass into here, using 8 centimeters, okay, as our radius. And last but not least, we are going to pinch our circle into the other point, and not our circle. You see, compass means Zirkel in German, and I'm messing those terms up from time to time. And now we are going to go for 18. And now, in a normal case, our intersection points should now give us this triangle. So we got the 7 centimeters here now, 7 length units. Now, we're going to have an intersection point up here. Let me see at first where the 9 centimeters hit off. It should be over here, exactly. And now if we were to place the last line segment, it should be exactly 8 long. And now we constructed ourselves a triangle, and that worked out. I think I swatting. If it enjoyed this video, it was nice. Subscribe to my comment channel if you like. And out to the next video. I wish you guys a flammable day. Ciao.